explained, and yeah, let's see how we can get going. We're gonna start in about 3 minutes, and I'll just offer him a 5+2 game on the Lichess server. So let's see. I wanna watch also my own stream to see if there's nothing wrong in it, to make sure I can hear myself and so on. And there are no sound or other issues.
Against ChessExplained.
Yes, so seems like it should work. Is the stream public? Yeah, I see 4 people are watching, so it must be public. Okay. Right, seems to work. So let's see. So for those of you who don't know what we're doing, so it's a dual commentary match, chess match. We're gonna play a race to 4 points, 5+2, blitz chess, and Chess Explained, also known as Christof Sielecki, he will also post his streaming at the same time, his point of view, and you can both the match from both of our channels. And each one from his own perspective. So we are 1 minute before, so let's see if I can challenge him to a game. It's not so easy. It says it doesn't accept challenges, so let's see if I can sort it out somehow. Let's have a look. Okay, in the meantime, I'll put the top board for you guys to see. Oh, it's not the right one. Okay. Here. You can just watch the top Blitz game. Try to challenge ChessExplained once again. Let's see if it's working. Okay, let's find him. ChessExplained. Yeah, now it works. Okay, so we want to play 5 minutes per side plus 2 second increment and random color. Yeah, so he asked for a few moments to adjust his board and so on. I'll have a look at my own stream in the meantime. I hope everyone can hear me well. Let's have a quick look at the chat. Sec. Okay, so far no messages. So I'm waiting for his approval to start the match, and we're going to play, as I mentioned. He says okay. I'll ask if I can start. All right. Wishing him good luck. And we are set. D4 on the board. He plays C5 on the second move. I'm assuming Benko is his intention. Yeah, we are transposing to the main Benko. Now I play the B6 line, the one I mentioned earlier in my videos. So D6, knight C3 seems like the right move order. And I should play A4 at some point. I'm assuming E4 first, and now castles and A4. Or queen takes B6, A4. I think I can start with knight D2 as well. Shouldn't make much of a difference. So the point is to go A4, A5. Actually, if he goes A5, I would prefer to go bishop B5 check, so I'm not sure if it was the correct move order. So far we are following the main line, kind of. At least I hope so. And if I get A5 in, I'm gonna have a little bit of space. Queen B7 is a unique move order. I haven't seen it. But I'll go A5 anyway. I don't see a big difference. I think you might want to go E6. So maybe I need to be careful. But if I go bishop E2, he goes A5. That's interesting. I have some time to think, so I might use it. So if I go a5, e6, knight c4 looks kind of good for me. Attacking d6. Okay, shouldn't be too bad. We'll see. Bishop d7. Ah, this is the point. He wants to prepare bishop b5, I'm assuming. It's a move I haven't encountered before. Knight bd7 is blocked, so if I can effectively prevent bishop b5, it might be annoying for my opponent. But I don't see a convincing way to do so. Alright. Don't want to take on b5. So how about I just play bishop c4? And castle, and then wait for him to take. Makes sense. Now castles. I don't think I'm missing anything. He's probably gonna go knight d7. Actually, queen b3 is an interesting option I missed, but yeah, now it's not as effective. Not sure. Let's just develop. But then he goes with the knight to e5. It's not so easy. Don't want to take on b5. So, what should I do? Queen b3. Rook b8. Knight e5 is coming. Okay, let's try to be a little bit aggressive. I'll go queen e2. Attacking b5, probably rook fb8 is going to be played, and now trying to prevent knight b5, knight e5 with this f4 move. I don't see any way he can punish me. Yeah, he's using the normal maneuver, knight to c7. Actually, it looks like a good position for black, I have to admit. I'm also a bit low on time, so I need to find the right idea, and I don't have great development also. Okay, rook a3 seems logical. And I'm considering some e5 related ideas. Knight takes makes the most sense to me. Yeah. e5 doesn't seem to work, as d5 is hanging. But d6 is also kind of hanging. Okay, let's just... Knight b5 is kind of a threat also. So I need to be careful. Okay, how about I just play knight here and ignore his idea. Let's see if I'm missing something. So knight b5, I just want to move my rook to h3 perhaps and try to organize something on the king side. At least I hope so. I want to stick a knight on b6 maybe later to prevent some counterplay if I can. He's leading by a lot of time, so it can't be good news. Yeah, knight f6 is coming if I go queen g4. So, need to be careful. I don't have much time, as mentioned. So, I think I'll just go queen to d3. Yeah, so rook on h3 is not ideally placed now. Queen g4, knight f6, queen h4 might have been a bit more challenging, but it felt wrong. Okay, how can I develop now? Continue my idea. I think I can go here, attacking the queen. And if he moves, I have some e5, f5 related ideas, but I need to make it work. I'm really not sure. Takes, takes, knight takes. Seems like I should have some attack going. Feels like it might work. But then again, it might not work. So, rook takes h7 seems like some form of an attack in the end. I don't have much time. Okay. So, it doesn't seem to work actually, but I don't have many alternatives, so I'll take the risk. With 46 seconds on the clock. The first game hasn't gone my way so far, but I'm still playing, so there is nothing dramatic happened yet, except for the time situation. So, if it takes, I'm not sure. Yeah, I pre-move this one, and now I have to come up with a good way to continue. Rook h7, rook f7 looks tempting, but bishop g7, and then I can check. Check, check. Seems like his king will run away. I don't see a direct attack, so I'll just go here. It feels like I should have something. But I'm not sure what. Okay, this is not what I was expecting for. How can I attack? Let's try this unique move, preparing some knight d5 ideas. ...22 seconds are not a lot. Knight d5. I have to go here, maybe it doesn't work, but I have to try something. Then rook takes f6 perhaps, if I have the chance. Rook is attacking the queen. Yeah, now rook takes f6. Seems like my best try. Okay, let's do it. See what happens. Feels a little bit desperate, but it might be good, who knows? 15 seconds are not a lot though, so I have to be a bit more quiet and concentrate on the position. Qg6, Should it work? I don't see why not. Okay, let's try it. Okay, 7. Knight h7. Here's knight e2 check. I don't see why it would be a problem. If I move the king somewhere, 7 seconds on the clock. It's quite stressful. Fortunately, I have the 2 second increment. I have so many choices with the king after knight e2, but I'll just go to h1. Okay, knight takes was my idea. Knight f6 is a big threat. If he takes, I wanted to take on d6. 7 seconds left. Queen d7, knight f6, takes. It's not very safe for me. Bishop g5. Is there. Okay. So, what is he going to do? It's getting complex. Taking. Okay, I'll take on d6 as I wanted. Now the queen is pinned. The rook is under attack. Position is extremely complicated. Knight f3 check looks nice, but king f2 simply. The knight h4 actually. Yeah, that's a bit annoying. Ah, but b8 is hanging. Okay, this looks good. Let's give a check. And take on h7. If rook g2, g7, actually, maybe I can play something else. Queen e8. I don't see any promising. Oh, 1 second, sorry. Knight f3 check. Oh, this is something I missed. 2 seconds left. I have to be quick. Oh. Okay. This is difficult to deal with. Yeah. Position is not ideal. I might just give a perpetual with my time control. What a stressful game. And an interesting finish. Okay. First game is a draw. So, I'm waiting for him to offer a rematch. I'm not sure if the idea is to look at the games right afterwards or continue the match. Let's see. Well, I'll just quickly mention that in this position, I feel like I should be winning. I can just take on h7, I guess. A queen f6 check. But I didn't see the immediate way, and with so little time, yeah, it was a bit stressful. Yeah, the position is extremely unbalanced. Okay, he offers a rematch. Let's go for game number 2. Now I'm gonna play black, so let's see what happens. So he's white, c4 on the board. What should I play? Grunfeld, Nimzow, Slav-related moves, Queen's Gambit declined. I think I just go c5, symmetrical English. Okay, play like this. What is he going to do? Oh, a3. 5a3. This is an annoying line. I played it against Zubov. And yeah, Alexander Zubov from the Ukraine. And I lost with the main line, and then I came up with a very interesting idea. This particular move order. And I didn't get a chance to play it over the board. It's kind of a novelty. I mean, it was played before, but not with the same ideas that I have in mind. which I think are very energetic and interesting. D3 is one of the main moves. And I believe now my move is b5. So let's see what happens. The point is to save a tempo on rook b8. Takes, takes. Yeah, I have to recollect my thoughts, but basically I didn't get a chance to play this variation over the board, and a friend of mine, an Israeli friend named Ophir Aaron, got two chances to play it, I think against Sofer, Ram Sofer, and Vadim Alakhatko, two GMs, and got good positions in both cases. And yeah, I introduced him to this idea and it worked perfectly. Now I have to remind myself what's the best move, because I think I can go either rook b8 or queen b6, but I'm really not sure. If I go queen b6, it looks like I might have some nasty ideas for the next move. And if I go rook b8, followed by taking on b4, it's a bit less annoying for him. Okay, so what should I do? Queen b6, he has to go knight a3. As far as I can tell, taking on b4 looks interesting, but a bit risky as well. Okay, what is the move? Rook b8. Rook b8, knight moves. Take on b4. Queen b6 feels like the right way, but knight a3. I have to come up with a move here after knight a3. So it feels like I should just go for the initiative, but I don't see a follow up. d5. What was the point? This line should be good for black. As far as I can tell. d5. Okay, knight to a3. Knight g4. Doesn't seem to work. Yeah, that's a shame. I'll just go rook b8 for now and see what happens. But I'm a bit disappointed that I didn't find anything, because queen b6, knight a3 should be the right way. Yeah, now it becomes a bit more complex. Doesn't feel right. Can I go some creative way? Just rook takes b4, maybe? And also go d5. Thinking too much, but I can't find my intended idea. d5 moves. I'll just take with the rook and I'll think about it. Yeah. Here, queen e4. Doesn't feel like I'm punishing him as I should. Okay, I'll go d5, just trying to be a little bit active. Once again, I'm 3 minutes down on the clock, so I have to play much faster now. And now I'm not sure how to protect my pieces over here. Okay, let's go here and see what happens next. The knight is protecting d5, so I'm not worried about this part. But the time, man, the time. Bishop d7 is coming. Position is roughly equal, I think. But I want to believe that I can try to push for something. Not sure how. Let's have a quick overlook here at my channel. Okay, I can't see how many people are watching. But I see. I'll have a look at the chat after the game. Knight f3, I'll move my bishop out, preferably with tempo on b7. Hard to say what's going on, despite the elusive equality that we have here. Okay, so this is interesting. Wants to exchange queens. So, and I can't really prevent it, so... Yeah. It's a bit annoying. Can I go queen d6, bishop f4? Knight c2, followed by something. Let's try it. Shouldn't be that bad. I prefer to keep the queens on the board because this queen on b5 is a bit misplaced now. My idea after bishop f4 is something related to e5, maybe with or without check on c2. I feel like I have a little bit of a development advantage. Okay, so people sent me messages that they are watching the stream. Please don't send me private messages on Lichess, by the way, while I'm streaming. Okay, this looks like an interesting move, but I can just go knight c2 and it will be very, very bad for him, as far as I can tell. Okay, let's try it. His king is going to be stuck in the center. I think white is just lost all of a sudden. Just take here, and if he takes there, bishop a6 or something, it looks terrible. King is in the center and all my pieces are coming very quickly. So that's a pity. For him. But there are still chances at any position. It's very important to be precise. So yeah. He has a threat. I don't think so. So rook c8 looks like a good move, preparing some queen c2 related ideas, and I don't think he can even develop, so yeah. One attacking idea that comes to mind is knight g4, bringing more pieces. Yeah, I think the position is quite terrible for white. Knight e4 was kind of a blunder. I think I'll have a look at all the games after we finish. Okay, so we resigned. So I'll have a quick look before, just at the final moments. So here, I wasn't sure what was going on. I'm assuming that he's also looking at the game a little bit before offering a rematch. And yeah, actually, I would like to check quickly. Right about this moment what might have been the right move, but I don't know how to check it on Lichess. There should be a button here somewhere, but okay, he offers a rematch already, so I guess I'll have to deal with it in the next game. Okay, accepted. I'm going to be white. I played d4 on the previous game. Let's try e4 now. See what happens. I'm assuming Rui Lopez is his main opening. I didn't have time to prepare, but yeah, I'm just, as far as I can tell, he doesn't play something too sharp. I think the Chigorin. But I would like to have an interesting game, so I'll go for knight d4. This is a more complicated line, I think. Let's say at least more unbalanced. So in this position, normally they either take or go knight f5 straight away. I take. Knight e4 is not possible because of bishop d5. Yeah, now either knight c4 or c5. This is main theory as far as I remember. c5 b3. Knight b6 or knight a5 is possible. And now some knight bd2 with h3. I had a game on the black side against Sutovsky. Knight fd7. Yeah, now... Ah, without c takes d4 actually. So... I think a4 is the move, but I can start with h3. I don't think he wants to take on f3. Just pre-move in case he does. Don't want to get time pressure once again. Yeah, now a4 should be the critical move. C takes d4, and there is a forced sequence over here. I don't remember all the theory, but I remember suffering a lot as black against Emil Sutovsky. Yeah, I took here. Rook e8 is a possible move, of course. Actually not sure what to play against it, so let's try to develop. Just go here, see what he does. The position is very complicated. There, as you can see, there's a lot of tension in the center and on the queen side. And yeah, I'm a little bit, I have a little bit more space, I would say, but not much. So the game is going to be very concrete. Yeah, I'm not sure what I want to do. So let's see, what does he want? This is a good way to start thinking. So I don't see a threat. That's a good sign. Now, can I go bishop d3 and attack b5? Does it make sense? I think it does. Okay, let's try, see what happens. When I'm curious and I'm not sure if something works, I just try it. And in the worst case, my opponent will just show me why it doesn't work, and I'll learn something. So either I gain something or I learn something from it. But the worst thing is to be willing to play a move and be too afraid to play it and then regret not playing it, especially during the game. It's not a good idea to think about what happened in the past. So I'm trying to focus on the next few moves. And okay, on the current position, I see that I'm threatening. I'm attacking b5, as I'm assuming everyone can see, and I'm trying to induce him to make a decision. Because normally, when there is tension between pawns in the center or even in the flanks, when one side is releasing the tension, in most cases it works in the favor of the other side. It's just a general rule. It doesn't work always, but the fact that he took first is, at least statistically speaking, in many cases will be in my favor. But then again, this concrete move might be good for him. So a5 seems like a useful move to insert. If he goes knight c8, then this knight will be less active. And now I have to find something. I feel like my development is better. He wants to go c4. And if I go queen c2, c4 might be annoying, but I'm not sure if he wants it so badly, because then after he takes it, c4 might be a little bit weak. So not sure if he even has a threat. Just want to develop somehow. One sec. Yeah, excuse me. So I feel like I should find some good move. Queen b1 looks right. Just remembered I forgot to look at the chat, so excuse me for it. Queen b1, rook b8 is a little bit unpleasant, so let me just think for a moment, see what happens. But a6 is hanging. Okay, queen b1 feels like an interesting way to develop and protect the bishop. Ask him some questions. Let's see what happens. Okay, c4 was anticipated. And the question now is what he wants. Maybe rook b8 in this particular moment. Yeah, now I have to move the queen away. It feels wrong for me. But what can I say? Bishop b4, bishop a3. Yeah, it's very complicated, once again, I have to mention. I don't know how to evaluate it, but it feels like it should be good for white. I don't know why, but I sense like my pieces are more active. This knight on c8 is a little bit far away from the game. If bishop b4 seems like the most reasonable move, as far as I can tell. And I don't know. Bishop a4 leaves this guy hanging. He threatens c3. Can go bishop a3, but then he takes. He also wants to take the pawn, actually. So can I do something concrete? Like e takes. Doesn't look right. e5, c3. You can't really attack in an effective way. What can I do? Bishop a3, bishop a5, and play for the initiative, perhaps. But how? Ed. c3. Well, I have to do something. I'm not a big fan of this situation right now. Bishop a4 takes on e5. e4, knight e5 might be an option. But again, not very promising to my eyes. Rook e3. Okay, I don't have much time. Let's just go with one option and see what happens. Just play here and think later. Yeah, I don't like my position very much. But for him, it's also not so simple to make moves, as far as I can say, as I can tell. If he takes, I'll take with the knight. Yeah, this looks logical. No, I'm not sure what to play once again. Maybe knight e5. He might gain some pawn. Okay, I'll go e5. And see what happens next. Knight f5 looks principled, forcing me to take. Then I have to come up with a good follow-up. And he basically got rid of all of his bad pieces, so to speak. The knight over there was his only bad piece. Yeah. Okay, what can I do? I don't see a threat other than taking here, but it's not a big threat. So I'll go here. Just preparing some knight g3. I need to find some way to put my pieces. Yeah, put the knight here. Ask the bishop where he wants to go. And now I think exchanging these guys won't be a bad idea. It shouldn't be a bad idea. But yeah, the c4 pawn is very strong. And he has some threats. Okay, I'm trying to prepare h5. Okay, I'm not sure what to do. Here's the open file also. Okay, let's go here. Be a little bit passive and see what happens with my time pressure. H5. feel like my position is worse, but I should be able to find some moves. It's not hopeless. H5, knight h4, knight to f5. Okay, he has rook b2 coming, but I have to allow it. So rook e7 prevented his queen from attacking, from covering the h4 square. Actually, rook b1 related ideas might be dangerous for me. I have to be careful, generally speaking, in this position, but yeah, nothing new here. So yeah, I just realized I forgot to look at the chat, so hopefully after this game I'll remember. Check. Can take on rook c1, rook c1 immediately. Let's do it straight away. Don't want to lose the a5 pawn. So we exchange the pair of rooks, and his rook was more active. I feel good about this trade. But I'm still not sure how to improve my position. My time situation is not getting better. Okay, I'll go rook c1. Preventing c3, I hope. He's trying to get it in anyway. Now I have to find a good move. I don't see any. Okay, I have to go somewhere. Let's put it here. Actually, c3 is terribly annoying, so I'm not sure what to do against it. c3 followed by c2. Okay, maybe this prevents c2 for one more move. We'll hold it down. Rook b1 looks strong for him. Knight e2. I have to try to block it. Yeah, a5 is hanging, I also noticed just about now, but maybe he won't have time to take it. At least I hope. He did take it. Okay, I need to find counterplay, and I need to find it fast. So knight to f5, trying to attack with what I have left. He takes. Okay, I don't have a threat. It doesn't look too promising. Let's go here, preventing some rook a1 ideas. At least I hope. 9 seconds, so I'll be a little bit more quiet. 96. We lost on time. Ah, that's a shame. That's a shame. I didn't want to win like this. Yeah. Had I saw his clock situation, I wouldn't have tried to win like this. I thought he had more time, actually. I wonder what's going on in the position. If he takes on h5, I can't really move. Actually, before we start the next game, I want to press the analysis board real quick. I hope it's fine. I'm really curious about that other position that we had, like, from the previous game, because it's really critical. So, it was like this. And something along these lines. And I remember black should be better here, but I don't know how. Yeah, I forgot my analysis completely, so yeah, he asks for a rematch. So this particular moment, computer evaluates it as better for black, but I don't know what's the right move. So yeah, it's really hard to say. Uh, I have no idea what's going on in this position. So if he plays it, if he plays it again, then I won't know what to do, but I'll try to think over the board. So in case you saw what I was looking at right now, because I'm capturing my screen, I'm not sure if it's capturing the entire screen or not. So I was trying to understand what's the evaluation, because I don't think the computer on Lichess actually shows the moves. So I'm playing my own novelty once again, and he's trying something else. So I'll look at it after the match, but this d3 line was very interesting. B5 also shouldn't be very accurate. I think I can take. And if c takes, I think I can go knight e5. Knight takes I also know, but rook b5 is new to me. I haven't seen this move. I haven't analyzed it before. So let's see. He's kind of threatening something. No, he just wants to finish his development. So I have to be very active. I have to try to be ruthless. Punish him for playing b5 for some reason. I remember that it should be better for black, but not why. So let's see. Knight a5 might attack this pawn, which seems weak at the moment. D3. Some knight jams. I don't see something too convincing. So he wants to go knight f3. What if I go knight d4 followed by d5? Doesn't make sense. Okay, knight a5 looks like a concrete idea, but how to follow through? I don't see anything smart. Once again. Okay, I found an interesting idea. Let's see. It's probably not working, but I'll try it. So I'm going knight e8. Must be a bad move, but we'll see. Preparing knight d6, and you cannot play d3 for the moment because this knight on c3 is hanging. So might be an interesting creative move. Yeah, now I want to attack this pawn, but he can go to c5. What a unique position. Knight a5, queen a4 maybe. So maybe I go from e5, queen b3, queen c7, d3. Shouldn't be too much. Knight a5 feels right. Just attacking this pawn. Yeah, now I should be able to follow through somehow. Just attack it more and more. So here. Yeah, now he wants knight d5. That's unpleasant. So how about I just go with my knight over here? Does it help? Not sure. Okay, I can just go d6 and back. Yeah, it feels like I messed it again. Okay, knight c4, rook b4. And I don't have time. D6, queen d8. Okay, I'll just try d6. I don't see why it's so bad. I mean, it might be good, okay for white, but I have to develop somehow. Knight d8 was probably not a good move. So, yeah. I remember analyzing a lot of different options, but these two variations that he played, I mean, at least the first move of these variations, I remember the evaluation was better for black, but to prove it in a blitz game is far from easy. Let's make a quick... Once again, I forgot to look at the chat, of course. So, everything seems fine, though. So I should just stop promising I will look, because I keep forgetting. He's thinking a lot for the first time in this game. I wasn't aware of his speed. I mean, he plays really fast in Blitz. I thought, I mean, I had a stereotype in my mind that because I'm younger, I should be able to play faster. And yeah, obviously this proved wrong. Knight b6 now is the move I expect. And then I go rook a6. In Blitz, to play fast, you don't have to be young or strong or older or necessarily stronger at chess. Just have to be experienced in Blitz. That's my take on the topic. So, knight f6 should be a good move. This knight is not doing anything. Let's bring it back. Could have played f6, but it felt wrong. After bishop d2, and if he takes, I'll take with the pawn. Let's have a quick look how many viewers we have. Okay, not too bad, but judging by the number, I don't think I'm being streamed live on Liches, so maybe I did something wrong in the title. We have 24 viewers with us. So, I should write leeches.org in the title of my stream. I might have failed to do so, I don't know. In this case, I hope to check the chat. You guys can tell me. So, I think I should take. Don't see a big reason not to, but yeah, for the moment he cannot play knight f3. This is at least a good sign. Yeah, now I should find some good move, but bishop f5 feels concrete. Like if he takes, I take on b1. If e4, rook a8, at least feels like I'm doing something remotely energetic. Yeah, now we get this exchange. And he wants to finish his development, which is a good thing to do in this case. I don't see a way to prevent it. Okay, I can try to attack e2 for one move and see if it affects anything. Doesn't look very smart, but I have to do something. And once again, I'm behind on the clock. He should castle somehow, but yeah, this move also looks reasonable. I think I'll go queen b3. Try to simplify. If it takes knight b3, and I'm a little bit more active for the moment. Yeah, he castled. Should be able to equalize, that's my idea. In this position, actually, yeah, I'll go rook a2, attacking this pawn, and then b5 maybe. He doesn't mind. Okay, I don't see a way to punish him. I have to go here. Let's exchange and hope I'm not worse. The pawn is running, so I'm not sure what's going on for the moment. He can stop it with bishop from d5. which is not very convenient for me. Or from a4, oh, he wants to trap my knight. That's nasty. I won't let him play here. Yeah, and try to release my knight somehow without losing the pawn. Maybe knight a3 immediately. But it feels like my position is worse. Yeah. Put it here for now. And bring the king over. Yeah, f7 is a weakness. Feels like I should be able to hold. But I would really like to be better. If possible. Okay, let's go here. Prevent king coming to c3, which is a bit annoying in my eyes. And I think the opposite colored bishop should be fine, so go here. Maybe pawn to f6. Trying to avoid losing it. 15 seconds, so I'll be a bit more quiet. King here. Should be close to equal, but yeah, I'm losing a pawn if I'm not careful, so he wants to go with the bishop to grab my pawns. So I have to go back somehow. That's a shame. Position is really tough to defend, I think, with 8 seconds. Okay, I should pre-move. Bring my king over and hope for the best. Not sure where I refer to by over, but just play fast. Want my pawn on dark squares so I can more easily defend them. But f5 is gonna be a weakness. Quite a big weakness. I don't want to have a major weakness on f5, but position is not good for me. That's for sure. Okay, let's try to save whatever is left. Hope I can bring the king to protect it if I need to. No, I'm not able to. Man, knight d4 is strong. Okay, what can I do? Let's take. See where I can bring this knight. Oh yeah. I'm almost getting mated. Fortunately, I found some counterplay in the last second. And suddenly, I have hope. Just pre-move king takes d5. Yeah. Just go. And the knight is hanging. I don't see a problem for now. I think I can equalize without too much trouble. Maybe I'm even better, who knows. Okay. Position has some potential to be better, but I'm not sure how to prove it. Yeah, but it's the blind bishop, so only Zugzwang can help me. Yeah, now the knight has to move and allow f4. It has to move again. It might be interesting if it's actually winning somehow. Yeah, this is stalemate, so I'll go here, and I can take actually. This is quite interesting, the fact that it wasn't completely drawn, that the knight couldn't get the f-pawn. Wow, what a weird endgame. I'd love to analyze it after we finish the match. Judging by the positions we had in the middle game, it should have been at least 2-2. But, I mean, 3.5 doesn't feel right against his half a point. But, yeah, what can I say? Just, I mean, luck is a very important part of chess, so... And I heard this quite often, I'm not sure if it's completely true, but I tend to believe that if someone is lucky very often, then in some of the cases it might not be pure luck, just like Carlsen keeps defending. Let's play a new opening. I tried d4, I tried e4 with main lines. This time I'll go bishop f4, the London system, and see what happens. Yeah, now knight c3 is the point. If he goes g6, preparing e4. Trying to get more aggressive take on the game. C6 is a good move. F3. I actually had a game like this in Biel about a month ago, or even less. Might have been 2-3 weeks. So, yeah, in this position. About 3 weeks ago, I was white against 2330 from Poland, who was very talented. He didn't play b5, he played bishop g7. And now I think I should play a3, just avoid b4 and preparing e4, if possible. So c6 immediately was a bit passive. I think he should have played bishop g7 and castles, and only after I go bishop h6, go c6. And this way, I will have wasted the tempo on the bishop, and then e4 will be less convincing. So in this particular line, it feels like I might be a little bit better, but I don't know for sure. In the game, I played bishop h6 in this position, or without b5 a3, and we transposed. And after he took, and queen a5, black got tremendous counterplay. So instead of e4, bishop h6 was a mistake. And while the computer said it was equal, it felt better for black during the game. So, yeah, I wouldn't recommend playing bishop h6 there. Yeah, now we get a typical position in the center, but it feels like white is more, I would say, better developed. But I'm not sure how to punish my opponent. Because if I take, he can take and go a6, and then try to take on c6 next. So I don't want to take straight away. Maybe I can go castles. It feels a little bit dangerous, maybe. But I have to do something, so yeah, let's just see what he does. I can't just sit and think like I do every game. And if I draw, then I win the match according to the... I reach 4 points, so... I mean, not that it matters for the game's sake. I would really like to prefer to just try to play interesting chess, but it feels like normally I wouldn't like to draw with white. So let's see. B4 is a threat, maybe, but then knight a2 is possible. I don't know. It's hard to say. Let's just go king b1. When in doubt, when in castle long positions, king b1 is a good move. Almost in any position. Yeah. Now I want to go just bishop e2 and take with the knight and maintain my lead in development. g4 becomes a threat, which I think he ignored. Not sure if he did it on purpose. I don't think he has a threat at all, so... I think I can just... Yeah, but... Doesn't feel right to go g4, knight f4. Feel like there should be something stronger in the position. Let's... What happens if I just develop? Or go h4, for instance. I don't think he even has a threat. b4... Okay, just go h4. Feels interesting, so... I don't know. Another interesting move might have been knight c1, knight b3, and trying to take control of the dark squares on the queen side. So, yeah, h4 could be an amazing move and could be very bad. It depends. It's very concrete. And for now, I'm just following my intuition, but it feels like it's putting more pressure on my opponent than just playing g4 and forcing knight f4. I like this idea of playing non-forcing moves to have potential to provoke mistakes. Yeah, now take knight d5 looks like I should be better. Then his knight will be a little bit off the game. If I go g4, knight f4, all the same. Takes, takes, takes. I can go d6 as well. B4, knight a2. Okay, b4 is a bit annoying, so I prefer to just get rid of his potential for attack and play solid chess, because with this bishop here against this guy, it feels like white should be slightly better. And my pieces are more centralized. So this is why I think he chose this more concrete approach and not taking back. If I go knight d5, what does he want though? I'm not sure. Let's just see. Ask him politely. Because knight e7 is a big threat. And if he takes will protect. I'll have two passed pawns. And actually the queen is hanging, so he doesn't have time to take even. Yeah, now rook d2 looks forced, but g2 is hanging, which I missed, but doesn't seem very important with the knight e7 check looming at us. Let's see. So I'm threatening to take on f4. He doesn't have time to take on c6. Now he kind of threatens to take on c6. Yeah, I would say he does. And this will open up his bishop, so I must have some concrete idea if I do something like this. How can I protect this guy on c6? Looks like such a nice asset for me. Yeah, I don't know. Knight f4, bishop f4. Okay, clearly I have an edge, but I want to be as precise as possible. Psachis told me this week in a training camp that a wise sentence, I'm not sure who said it, but when you have a better position, it's important not to rest and do not hurry, as they say, but and just concentrate more and try to finish the game as effectively as possible. And here I don't see how, so yeah, I think I'll just go for the modest approach. G2 is also hanging, so yeah, I don't want to open his bishop though. Knight b4 maybe? Bishop c5. Yeah, I'm a bit annoyed by my options. Okay. I have to take something, so yeah, can't think for my entire time in a Blitz game. That's a shame. So rook f1, bringing the last piece to the game, to the open file. As mentioned, my position is probably still better, but I have to be much more precise. Yeah, this knight b4 looks very annoying for my opponent actually. Knight takes e4. Knight c6. Yeah, it's not so easy for him. Rook c8 looks forced, because bishop d6 is my idea. And just want to give a check. And maybe go e5, I'm not sure. Can also go back to d5 somehow. Just protect this guy. So many tempting options. Too many good choices can be a curse. Okay. Let's play this weird looking move. Protecting the pawn. Preparing some e5 ideas. And then knight d5 is my the main point behind this rook e2. So I can afford knight b5 later. So okay, knight a4 isn't very threatening. I can just go e5 as I wanted. Preventing all counterplay. Ah, he wants to prevent my knight d5. Okay, no time. Let's attack f7. He can't really defend it. Well, this quite rapidly becomes bad for my opponent. Knight c4 looks like a good try. Then knight d5. Threatening knight d7. I guess we'll see. So I have a pawn up and threatening to take a second one. Knight c4 will threat knight d2 check in case I take on f7, so I have to be careful. This is why after knight c4 I intend to just go knight to d5. So let's see. This is a good move actually. Preventing my I see. Okay. So we found a way to defend. I don't want to make a draw just like this, obviously. But I have to find a move, and I don't have much time. Let's just pass the move and see what happens. Okay. Not the best strategy, generally speaking, but I don't want to just make a draw. Okay, knight c5 looks interesting. Interesting enough to play at least. If he goes back, it should be a good sign. No time for me. Okay, let's see what happens. Any tactical ideas? Take. 7 seconds left. My position is not becoming much stronger. Okay, oh yeah. He defends if he takes with the rook, actually. Should play knight e5 maybe. Okay, let's go here, attack b5, g5 looks good, maybe, it might help him actually create a passed pawn, so I'm not sure about it, but no time, yeah, now, maybe c3, kind of, but no, rook d2 is very strong. Okay, I have to defend somehow, preparing to put my rook somewhere active. Not sure where. Let's go here and hope for the best. He has some mating ideas with rook d7. I have to be extremely careful. Okay, going here. Here. Yeah, and I have this one to save myself. I think he missed my idea. Okay, and I think now my position is quite safely winning. Okay, don't want to help him too much. So what can I do? Let's go here. It doesn't look like a very good move, but it might stop him from advancing. Let's go this way. Oh, I just missed. But I'm still... I think I should be better. Okay. Okay. Feels like I didn't play it correctly in the time pressure, but a draw is a good result. I mean, under this time pressure circumstances, so I can't say I complain. I can't complain about it. And let's have a quick look at the Lich's screen and at the chat. See what happens. If I'm being streamed on lichess.org, I think there is some problem. Yeah, for some reason my name is not mentioned on lichess.org. I don't know why. Maybe because I use the capital? I'm just trying to solve the problem. I'll have a quick look at his title to see if there is a difference. Maybe if I use a small L instead of a capital L, there will be a difference. I'll try to change the title. Okay. And have a quick look at the chat, of course, see if someone... Yeah, my stream wasn't public. So... So it was unlisted, I assume. But I tried... No, now I see it, actually. Yeah, what a pity. But at least in the archived version, people will be able to see it. So let's change it real quick. I should have known better than that. So people could only access my stream through his, through the description on his stream, and or if they saw my Facebook post. This was It feels. One sec. I'll go straight to analyzing the games after I make sure that I'm being shown. Yeah, so you can say that this was really an underground stream from my side. Okay, so let's go straight to analyzing the games. So I should click on my account and then see the games. So we played overall 5 games. Okay, let's have a look. The first game was a draw in the Benko Gambit. Just making sure. Now everyone can see me on the Lichess site. So now it's finally public. Little bit late. So let's see. The first game out of the 5, I'll go straight to the beginning. I played d4. And he went for the Benko Gambit. As you can see, this is the starting position of the Benko Gambit. I explained why I go with this particular move order in my videos. And one sec. Yeah, so b6. So the opening, in the opening you play the line, quite a sophisticated move order, which I didn't know before taking. Followed by bishop d7 here. Somehow playing this move order. I assume I could have prevented it somehow. But I think it's actually theoretical. I am almost sure that I've seen it before. And I have it in my analysis. And I also think it was mentioned in Kirill Georgiev's book, Squeezing the Gambits. I have to see... what's the right way in my analysis. Actually, now that the stream is finished, I think I can quickly check. So, one sec. Because I'm really curious, I don't want to wait until the stream is over. Okay. So... Yeah, I'm just retrieving the moves. Okay. So in well, as far as I can see, it's not mentioned in my analysis. So yeah, he did a good job in the preparation there to surprise me. I'll hit the computer on Lichess to have a quick look at the evaluation. Actually, maybe it's a better idea to do it only after I finish. Everyone can press on the computer evaluations and see them without me. If you just enter this game on Lichess, you can click on my name and see the game and press on the computer analysis. So I'll just say what's on my mind. Bishop c4 was my sophisticated way to try to deal with bishop b5. Yeah, normally I'm not used to dealing with opening problems before move number 20 or so. I'd like to consider myself to be well prepared. So yeah, in this particular case, I feel like I messed up in my home preparation, I would say. Now that I look at it, rook a3 looks like a good idea. So I'll just press analysis, I think it would be better. Okay, so instead of bishop c4, rook a3 feels like a good move. And preparing to meet bishop b5 with some rook b3 ideas. I can't really say what's going on, but I'm sure after queen c7 he will not lose material, so yeah, maybe it's not very convincing. Okay, so I should be able to deal with it somehow. I'll check it after the stream. Bishop c4 looks interesting, castles, and what can I say now? Knight d7. And now I really wanted to avoid this knight e5 idea, which forces me to go back with the bishop, because taking is really bad from structural point of view. So maybe b3 is also an idea to maintain the pressure, but I didn't like it. So I went queen e2 followed by f4. Feels like an aggressive idea that shouldn't be too bad. And now, unfortunately, this bishop on c1 is not participating in the game. So had it been on g5, it would have been much easier for me to attack, but since I'm underdeveloped, it's not easy to get e5 and f5 in. So it's a very typical idea, normally speaking, in such positions to play like this, but with the knight on e8, he's prepared for it quite well. So yeah, I think what I played is reasonable, trying to develop this rook from here, and the knight takes. Yeah, preparing his knight b5 idea, and now I want to have a rook lift somewhere in the king side. But yeah, I can't really say what's going on. So what to do? If I go knight a4, as I did in the game, knight b5, it didn't seem to be too convincing. But this is the typical idea. So maybe rook a3 was not the most precise, because I must somehow be in time to play knight a4, knight b6 and stop his counterplay. So yeah, maybe just waiting with king h1 or something. But once again, knight c7, and he waits with knight b5. I could go knight a4, but so it feels like black should be already completely fine here. So yeah, I'm not very happy with what happened in the opening. And now, yeah, knight f4 looks good, like I have to be able to move the rook somewhere. Rook h3 looks like the most natural square. Yeah, and I'm quite happy about this queen d3 move, despite the fact that it wasn't my original plan. I really wanted to go queen g4, and I was counting on the fact that I'm attacking this knight, and that if he makes a random move, then I might go queen h4 next, attacking h7, preparing some e5 maybe, or knight c3 followed by e5 or f5, just to try to mate him somehow. But in the game, I realized after this move, he has knight f6, and the e4 pawn is also hanging. So if I go queen h4, I wasn't very pleased, for example, after h5. So, yeah, I think it's the right evaluation. So, here after queen d3, the position shouldn't be too bad for me, but again, I had like 3 minutes less on the clock, and yeah. Now, queen b5. And in this position, yeah, the computer points out in the notation, I'm not sure if the viewers can see it, knight c3 is an inaccuracy. Knight ab6 was the best, but I wasn't sure what to take back with. I'm assuming the a pawn, but it feels wrong. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, knight ab6 was the best, despite the fact that it's not very natural to my eyes. This looks much more natural. And yeah, computer, by the way, points out that this is 0.5 for white and this is equal, so it shouldn't be worse. Yeah, now e5 is a really bad move. Should have played rook f2. I have no idea why, probably to prevent queen c2 with the exchange of queens. And I don't see my follow-up. So despite the computer evaluating this position as equal, I feel like practically it's worse in classical chess and especially in Blitz. So yeah, e5 is just my energetic attempt to save myself. Taking was a mistake apparently. Rook b4 was the correct move, which we both missed, with the idea to play queen c2 here, and the endgame is just better for black. Yeah, d takes e5, I took, which was another mistake. I pre-moved this in the time pressure. I remember thinking that d6 might be interesting, but yeah, computer doesn't mention it. So fe5, let's have a look quickly at d6, the evaluation. So yeah, it's also much better for black, it's even worse than the game. Okay, so fe5 says it's a bad an inaccuracy. I should have taken with the knight, I have no idea why. Because once again he has rook b4, of course. Yeah, and after I move the knight, knight e5 is very strong. Yeah, so we both missed rook b4 throughout the game. Now suddenly I'm okay again, but yeah, I missed the right idea. I played queen e4, and allowing this f6 move, I should have gone queen e3, also hinting at h6 square. So if he goes f6, queen h6 is quite strong. So yeah, I completely missed this idea as well. F6, d6 was a practical try, which kind of worked. I think I was winning at some point even, but well, according to the computer, not that it matters in this position. I should play just bishop f4 solidly, and shouldn't be much worse, only a little bit, something along equal plus, so black is slightly better. Yeah, d6, I kind of like this move. And now it's ed6 followed by queen c4, which was the most precise, threatening knight e2. Black is just winning. Yeah, in Blitz it doesn't feel so easy. Knight d5, queen b7, queen c4 was the correct move with equality once again. After queen b7, white is winning, thanks to this rook f6 move, which is actually quite nice. I guess he missed it. Ef, knight f6, king h8, yeah, and queen g6 was precise, and now knight h7 was also very precise. Queen h7 was a mistake, and yeah, now I should have just taken on h7 and on d6. According to the computer, this is a mistake. I don't like to evaluate moves like this as mistakes, because yeah, it's still much better for white, more than plus 3. So queen d6 is really not so bad. Rook g8 is a blunder, and yeah, I should have taken immediately, because if he takes with the king, I have queen h6 mate, and now I can just go queen f6 followed by bishop h6 and easily win the game. Would have been much easier. Yeah, rook h7 immediately. I was trying to be sophisticated with this check, which doesn't ruin anything yet, but yeah, I didn't see the follow-up. I guess I should just go with some random check. And well, actually, do I have queen b8, queen a7? Ah, queen h3. It's pinned. Let me demonstrate. Yeah, and this is now pinned. So it doesn't work. Okay, so in this position, I should have just played check and then take here once again. Forcing this, and once again, I'm very close to winning. Maybe completely winning already. Bishop g5 now is completely winning for black. And queen h3, is there a reason? And now he only had to do was to play rook g8, and I think I can more or less resign, because queen e5, rook, the other rook comes to g7, and I cannot take because of knight f3, and I'm just losing. So, yeah, this was a horrible blunder. I'm still much worse, rook g5, and he should be very close to winning again. But in the game, knight f3 is the final blunder of the game, and we made a draw. What a poetic finish for the beginning of this match. So, let's look at the second game. So, what do I press? How do I go back? Okay, let's do it like this. So, this was the first game. Let's look at the second game. Any comments from the chat? I can't leave it in the background, unfortunately, but I can try to put it on the side here. Let's see if anyone says something. Someone mentions something about the Benko Gambit, suggested by Simon Williams. Yeah, it's an interesting line, but I don't think it should refute the Benko, the line mentioned in the chat. But I didn't check it very deeply. Let's look at the second game analysis, and we have about 4 games to go. Okay, so he went c4, I unleashed my novelty, which Ophira Aron, my good friend, played twice on the board using my preparation with great positions. So this a6 line is quite rare. I don't think it was ever played by a grandmaster. And well, the point is to go b5 immediately and saving a tempo on rook b8. And not only that I save a tempo, but the rook on a8 might be more active in case we exchange. So, yeah, d3 is one of the most principled moves. And obviously I should go b5. And he has many different options. I just remember that taking is not the most precise, at least not not to take twice. I think he can probably go knight f3, I go d5, maybe it's not too bad for white. But yeah, I cannot say, I remember black should be better, but I don't know why. So I'll quickly check it, because I really wish I could see the right move. So in the game I was thinking for like 2 minutes, I don't know. Rook b8, queen b6, both look tempting. Even d5. And it's a bit annoying to know that black should be better, but not to know why. And yeah, so this is a bit of a problem with the memory of analysis without understanding of the position. So it's a good idea to work with a board, with an actual physical board, and not only with the computer, and come up with the right ideas behind the moves and sort out all, work out the tactics. So knight f3 was played. No, this is just a move I suggested. Knight b5, rook b8. If I go queen b6, knight a3 felt like it was forced, and computer says equal. Now a little bit better for black, but I don't see a move being suggested by the computer. So, no, equal again. Okay, let's just say that maybe my memory misled me. And here I went rook b8. Rook takes b4. Position is equal, more or less. Nothing too important to say, I'm developing. Queen a4 felt wrong. I would recommend white to finish his development with knight f3 and castles, of course, and just the position is very close to a draw, I would say, because everything is so symmetrical. So, and nobody has weaknesses. So queen a4 feels wrong because I'm better developed as well. Queen b6, and now, one sec, yeah, queen b5 was played, which is another inaccuracy, and I think queen d6 was really powerful, because exchanging queens should be harmless for my opponent, but after queen d6, I'm just, this queen is just misplaced. So for example, if knight f3, I think I can just go d4, as yeah, there is a line here mentioned by the computer, but yeah, knight d1, knight fd5, and this position is better for black because of his activity. It's not winning, but it's very, it's much better and much easier to play, especially in blitz. Knight e4 was just ruining the game. I don't think there's anything to see after knight c2 check. His king is in the center and the game is essentially over. Rook c8, ed3 check, and I think there's nothing else to see. So yeah, I'll quickly check what my analysis say here after knight takes b5. I don't mind sharing it with the audience. Let's see in the chat. Thanks for the advice, but I don't feel like saving the analysis at the moment. Let's have a look. Where did I save it? So, yeah, rook b8, rook b4 was correct, and it's just equal. So I remembered, my memory failed me. The position is equal, and at least I played the right moves. Yeah. And just, yeah, I'm probably better in other cases where he takes twice on b5, and I have queen b6. So, yeah. So let's have a quick look. Yeah, I don't know what to say about the position. It's very complicated. So, despite being relatively symmetrical. So, let's move on to the next game. So, three games left. This is game number three. So, we played... I was white, I tried e4 this time. Played the Ruy Lopez. Playing through the moves really fast because it's just main theory. This line is already... played a couple of times, and here after h3, oh, I should press analysis. Okay, now after h3, this position should be I think slightly better for white, but yeah, a4 is strong, introduced by Sutovsky against me, I believe, for the first time, and I was black and I suffered. Rook e8 I think is not a bad move, but yeah, it doesn't pose immediate problems for white. So, yeah, here bishop d3, as I suspected, was not the best. And I think my opponent demonstrated quite well what happens. So, what's the best move? I cannot... I only see the evaluation. The computer doesn't suggest the move. So, let me just see what happens if I put queen e2. The evaluation is more or less... the same like bishop d3. It's really hard to say how, what's the most precise. Yeah, queen b1 is the best according to the computer. Okay, at least it gives quite a big evaluation in white's favor. Ah, but now it goes down a little bit. Okay, I really can't say, so let's just leave it at that. Bishop d3 is interesting, still slightly better. And yeah, nothing special going on. D5 is actually not the best. Ah, it felt good for black. So what might be Maybe if I press, there is a button here where I can request analysis. No, I don't see it anywhere. Okay. So far we didn't make any big mistakes, but I really want to know what's the best move here for black, so I have to find it and see the computer evaluation. I wonder why I cannot see the computer moves. So here, okay, a5 looks logical, but it's bad. Plus one, almost. Bishop f6 maybe. Also quite good for me. I thought I have, should have an advantage. Okay, but it's quite complicated. I don't know what's the move. Options, display arrows. Okay, I'm not sure if this is such a great idea, but we'll try. Computer arrows. Okay, so now we will see what's the recommendation by the computer. It can be a good thing, it can also be a bad thing. Now I see why I couldn't find it. So the move is knight d5, taking advantage of this pin and getting some counterplay, going from b4 and f4, I guess. Another suggestion was c takes d4, I think. Yeah. What's the point if I take? Knight d5, yeah. If I take like this, knight d5 anyway. Yeah. Exploiting this bishop on d3. So, as mentioned, knight d5 and cd4 both not the most logical moves in my view. And now we play this d5 move, which for some reason is not accurate. a5 is right. Now bishop f1 was very strong, just running away from the pin. Yeah, I made it far too complicated than it should have been. There is just a pin, I should just go away from it. Bishop f1, and if c4, ed, and c4 is weak. So he has to take, and I just have better development and an edge. So this knight, once again, is the reason white is better. And also the fact that I have a bit more space here on the queen side, and this might be a weakness. So queen b1 was a big mistake, wow. Such a big mistake. Instead of having a very pleasant advantage, I'm slightly worse. Not slightly even, much worse. C4, rook b8. He just played the most precise moves, but fortunately so did I. I'm quite happy with my defensive skills in this game. Knight f1 wasn't the best, but didn't change the evaluation very much. Bishop c3, seems like I'm being very tenacious. And now h4 was finally, I cracked a little bit. Bishop takes b4, knight e2 was the most solid way. They're just transferring this knight to c3, possibly, or just waiting to see what he does. Okay, so h4 was an inaccuracy. H6, and now, yeah, bishop takes b4 doesn't feel right, but what can I say? The evaluation keeps changing, but we just played the most natural moves. Rook e7 felt practically inaccurate because it allows knight h4. And despite what the computer says, I feel like, especially in a blitz, I get some squares for my pieces. So I'm quite happy. Yeah, despite the fact that computer says it's minus 2, as you can see, it's very easy to go wrong here with black. The most precise move, rook back to b2. Actually, in the game I was intending rook c2, missing that there is this tactical idea. And my position is just lost. So, yeah, rook b2 is really strong. So, we both missed it, I guess. And after rook b2, I should just go queen e3 with a dead lost position by computer standards. Okay. Rook a1, rook a1. So this was very much in my favor because we basically exchanged this rook for this rook. which is obviously not something black would like. So we got the same position without these rooks. Queen c7, again, not precise. Rook b3 followed by queen b8 or rook d3, yeah, is deadly. Rook c1, well, nothing smart going on so far. Knight d6, again, a very tenacious move. Did I have a better move? Rook e1, of course. Yeah. Okay, knight d6. Now queen e3. I managed to find a lot of good moves in the defense. Yeah, now this was my chance. After many, many moves of suffering, knight e2 was my chance to equalize. And it's actually a fairly easy move. There is a pin, and I'm just exploiting the pin by putting pressure on the pawn. It's a very basic thing to do. I was just too focused on the king side. I didn't believe I could take this pawn. So yeah, he played bishop f5, I took with the knight, and rook a3 is a mistake. Queen b4 is very strong. King h2 was another strong move. He's threatening rook a1, so it's a prophylactic move against it. King f8, another mistake. Queen b4, but now it's already far from easy for to play with black, because all the pieces are kind of I mean, this pawn is very close to falling. This knight is extremely active, so I have a lot of chances. Knight e7, knight d6 are in the air. So yeah, he played king f8. Knight d6 was correct, I guess. Queen d3 is a bit too much for my skills. What's even the point? To get to h7 somehow? I don't know. Okay, knight d6. Queen d8. Now he set a little bit of a trap, I at least so I thought. If I go here, queen h4 check. Yeah, and if I go king g1, rook a1, and d4 is hanging. Yeah, just like this, and I'm probably much worse again. So I sensed the danger and I played g3, and queen g5, and actually I had queen f3. The first chance in the game to actually get an advantage after being lost for so long. Yeah, queen f3. It's not very difficult, protecting h5 and attacking f7. I just didn't want to leave this rook hanging. I didn't notice this f7 threat. It was so deadly. So rook c3 was still fine. I'm still close to equal. And unfortunately for him, instead of just playing some fast moves and maybe making a draw after queen takes e3, so for example rook c8 check. Actually, I was intending to play here, which is much worse for me. So I had to find rook c8, and I should have enough counterplay for a draw. Okay, overall a very high level game for a blitz, I think. I'm very proud of how I defended, but I'm disappointing myself in the openings again and again, and I would like to think of this part as my strong suit. And yeah, my opponent is not an active chess player, so at least not that I am aware of. So I would expect myself to be more better prepared, or at least solve the opening problems faster and more easily. And in both the terms, I was wrong. So this game was fascinating, I think, but the end was a bit tragic. And let's have a look at the last two games. So I press my name once again. See what's going on. Chess Explained was white. Oh, this game was fascinating. Actually, the end game, I'd like to analyze it in a moment. So let's first look at what happened before the ending. He played the same opening. Yeah, we entered my line. And a takes b5, c takes b5. I remember there's knight e5 followed by d5, and black is better, because here after knight c4 I should be better. It cannot prevent d5. I remember some vague line like this, and if he takes, there was some line where he takes, I don't remember how, something like this, and I should be better. I don't know exactly how, but black is playing for advantage in one of these while sacrificing a piece. So cb5 is not the best. I even remember this move existing, And somehow I can attack c4. I'm not sure how. Oh no, d5 I think was the right move. And then if he takes, he cannot go knight c3 because I have some knight cb4 ideas. I think so. Threatening some queen b6. But I might be wrong. Maybe it's... Yeah, and if d3, some knight a7. Anyway, the position is better for black here. Let's see what the computer evaluates. I think it's like minus one. Yeah. Okay, so he played probably the best move, which I didn't analyze. I remember analyzing the other two moves. Rook b5. Yeah, and where is the arrow? Knight e8. Oh! Yeah, that's a pleasant surprise. But... Wow, my 98 move that felt so horrible during the game, two moves later, is proven to be the best move. So, let's see what advice people give me in the chat before I continue. Well, nothing special that I can tell. Alright, so... Let's have a look. After rook takes b5, rook a1 apparently is the best, but knight e8, the fact that it's better for black is really pleasing for me. So, yeah, I'm very happy to discover it. And now rook b1 he found, and now I should have followed the same pattern, knight d6. I was kind of afraid of c5. This knight c4 move is something I failed to understand. But now I get it. This knight is hanging, so we cannot really attack my knight, and queen a5 is coming quite fast. So if he goes knight b5, d5. Wow. That's some high-level stuff. D3, and I'm assuming queen a5 check. Bishop f5. Okay. So, yeah, this is better for black. But still, it's far from easy. Even the computer changes its mind every few seconds. And now black is much better. Mm-hmm. How exactly? Queen a4. Yeah, that's ridiculous. I mean, so many good moves in a row. I mean, and he just played a sideline. Rook takes a sideline within a sideline. And I have to find all these moves. So c5 is what I was afraid of. I went knight a5. Still slightly better for white. For black, sorry. Yeah, now I should have played d6, just naturally exchanging and take with the knight, and it should be better. Yeah, quite easy. But queen c7, I completely misevaluated d4. I thought I have d6 and I can put pressure on him. Yeah, and with knight d5, yeah, the other thing happened. I was under heavy pressure for the entire game. Cd6, queen d6. To be honest, I am not very eager to analyze this position. So I was suffering during the game. Although this knight b6 was a mistake, so or not. Computer says it's the best move, and then a move later thinks black is better. That's weird. So maybe I'm fine. Anyway, probably somewhere along this position. Yeah, queen e6 was not the most precise. Had I gone queen a6, I would have prevented queen d3. And queen c2, rook e8, it just puts pressure on e2. And yeah, should have pressure on my opponent. Maybe I have some chances to press, or at least to beat the better side of an equal position. So queen e6, queen d3. Yeah, knight c4 is more precise, but it's a bit scary for me. To play like this, it feels like if I'm not careful, white can be winning with the d-pawn and my pieces being a bit loose. So queen b3 felt like the right call, but now b5, yeah, definitely b5, and rook a1 only later. I just lost the full tempo, which almost cost me the game. Bishop c6 was extremely strong. I was expecting bishop d5. And yeah, then I have time to release my knight, but fortunately I had knight c2 and knight a3. Had I gone b4, this position felt wrong. But why? Where is the arrow? Ah, king f1. Okay. So king f1. And he comes faster. And this pawn on b4 is a bit weak. So, yeah. Let's change the camera angle a little bit. So is this... yeah, this might be a little bit better. So, knight to a3, bishop d5. So as I mentioned, I'm not very eager to look at this position. It feels almost lost. I have no idea how to defend it. It's extremely unpleasant. But in the game I was trying to like survive for the longest time possible. And maybe I won't lose. King e8 was, I think, a smart idea because I was afraid of bishop g8, and if I move the pawn, then bishop h7, and he gets one of my pawns. So I was preparing king f7 when the bishop is on h7. But h4 is very strong. And now moving the h pawn was a mistake. I think I should just leave it here and wait and see what happens. And maybe it still draw, objectively speaking. So... yeah, in this position, one sec, let's see what people are writing. The green bar at the top corresponds to the engine depth. Uh-huh. Okay. I see. So I need to let it reach full depth. Okay. Thanks for the advice, Matthew. So, here... let's go back to the analysis. Bishop e7 looks okay, and h6 felt wrong, at least practically, because then the f5 pawn will be weak forever. I think h5 maybe can try to save this guy, but it feels like in practical game it's very close to lost. Anyway, f4 is a mistake. Let's just ignore it for now. Yeah, just allowing this is really bad, but somehow I'm not lost. Bishop g6 was the best. And if king e6, bishop e8. Okay, that's some deep stuff. Trying to slowly improve. Okay, d5, king d6 was a mistake. Yeah, I almost got mated there. Knight b5 was the best, just preventing knight d4 straight away. And apparently the position is not so bad. I have knight d6 coming. If bishop e6, I go here, and I prevent the knight d4, and this is back to the game. So now knight d4 is overwhelming. He allowed me a transposition, and suddenly black is fine. King c4, knight c7. Wow. This was a losing move. Why? Bishop f7, and knight d4, knight f5, just deadly. I can't prevent it. So knight c7, the move that I thought was finally releasing me from this bad position was a blunder. Knight a3 check, followed by knight c2, and knight takes e3 was the way. Okay, he went here. Once again, oh, knight f5 is so strong. I guess we both missed it, yeah. Oh, that's an easy move actually. Just takes, 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 and the game is over. Just the pawn endgame is completely winning. So, instead, he played this, which allows me to get counterplay. And suddenly, before we knew it, I was better. I think he should have played more actively, king c4. Yeah, preventing bishop c5, and then I cannot take. And some knight move. Or h5, trying to get my pawns with the knight as quickly as possible. Searching for counterplay. King c5, bringing the king over. Should not... play passively, even in such a position with not many pawns. Now suddenly black is winning according to the engine. But how exactly? Let's see. What's the most precise? Did it say bishop takes d4? Why is this so strong? King f4. King c4. I'm just going for the queen endgame. I misevaluated this line. Yeah. Okay, so bishop b6, king c4, bishop a7. I was afraid to go for the queen endgame, but it might be really strong. Let's see. Ah, knight e2 now. But had he gone back, Now bishop d4 might be even stronger with the pawn on h5. Anyway, moving forward. Knight e6 was very strong, but yeah, who can play this with seconds on the clock? And yeah, computer gives an edge for black. Oh, f5 is amazing. Wow. I didn't play this move because I was afraid of this. But this is absolutely amazing. Because if he gets to h1, it's a draw. But for some reason, with my king here and the bishop here, he has to move the king farther. And I don't think he can make it. Let's have a sample line. So if he goes king c4, I'm just going to g4 and he will not make it. And I'm winning. The bishop covers the g1 square, so we cannot get king f1, king g1. So king c4 is not very challenging. King d6 looks like the more challenging move. And now king g4, king e5 should be a draw. No, it's not even a draw. If I take here, it's still completely winning because the king is cut. Wow, that's nice. So king g4 is just winning. So this f5 move is, I mean, insane. I mean, had I seen it, I would have been extremely proud. I was afraid of knight takes f5. So king h4, a blunder actually, allowing king e6. Yeah, I'm not very proud of how this unfolded, but after his mistake and my mistake, now he has king f3. I don't know. I'm not sure if king g5 is such a mistake. Is this? Ah, yeah, this is much better. Okay, so yeah, just played passively for no reason. And here, had he played knight e8, it would have been a draw, because he threatens to. Now he can succeed in taking the f6 pawn. So for example, like this, knight e6 check. So I have to play some random move, and then he can capture and go king g2, and it's a draw. This is called a blind bishop. So, yeah. And this position suddenly, at first when we played it in time pressure, I was sure it's an easy draw and that all that's going to happen is we will make some moves and then I will let him take on f5. But then suddenly I realized that if I stalemate his king, then the knight has to move somehow. Let's have a quick look, because I think this position is the most fascinating from the entire game, as far as I'm concerned. So if he goes king h2, computer gives -3, but if he doesn't go up, it might mean that it's just a fortress. So let's say he just moves his king back and forth. What can I do to try to get this knight away from g7? So computer suggests check. And h3 looks okay. Let's say I'm moving somewhere. I don't think I can improve my position, because the moment I go king g3 with stalemate ideas, he has knight f5, and I'm not covering this square like in the game. In the game, my pawn was on f5 and my king was on g3 covering f4. You'll see it later. So yeah, king g1. No, this was just played. King h2. And yeah, if I go king g3 as mentioned, he can also give knight h5 check, but just for the sake of explanation, assuming my bishop was protecting, he can always give a check and go back. So this is just a draw actually. This position I cannot win. But in the time pressure, sometimes the most difficult thing to do is just sit and wait. So he wanted to force the capture of the f6 pawn instead of just waiting passively. So knight e6, it's kind of funny because I want to go back a few moves a little bit earlier in the game, in the end game. So somewhere around here, instead of playing actively, he was waiting with his king on c4 and c3, and he should have played actively. And in this position, where passive defense was the right thing, the one we just got, he tried to play actively with the knight. And it's still not lost. I go f5. I think he can still draw. But if he moves the king like this, h3, king g2, let's say I move the bishop. And now I'm sure there is some pattern. But this was my idea. Yeah, that's the key. That's something we both missed. So, obviously it's very dangerous for white, because if he moves the knight to the wrong square, I just go f4, and then I use the same technique, like in the game, to push the pawn. But here, he can just go knight g7, attacking it, and if f4, knight h5, forking the king and pawn, and it's a draw. He just pre-moves knight takes f4. So yeah, I'm not very happy with the fact that it's not winning. But maybe there are chances, I don't know. Computer just wants to go back and forth. Doesn't feel so right. Maybe if I put the bishop on e5, I want to try a plan. Let's quickly analyze this position that didn't happen in the game. Let's say I put the bishop on e5 to prevent knight g7 related ideas. And then I go some king g3. Knight d4, wow. Okay, but let's say you miss it. h2, not king h1, and some king f3 or something. But then I block my own pawn. So king here, again knight d4. Knight e6 and knight g5 check. But he has to find all these sneaky ideas with the check. Otherwise it's not so easy. Yeah, he has to find this check. But yeah, this might have been my best try. But for some reason, the position we got in the game, yeah, he made a very bad idea, a very bad plan. Once again, just waiting with the knight. Okay, you can't pass the move, but knight g7 would have saved the game instantly. This one allowed f4. So knight d4 as well was a draw, same idea. And now after f4, knight h3 is an instant draw. Why? Because knight g5 and knight d4 check. Once again, some knight checks, some tricks involving knight checks. So in this position, after knight e4, I wonder when it suddenly became lost. Maybe here. So king f3 wasn't the best. This also looks like a draw to me, but who knows? Feels like it should be a draw. Anyway, he needs to defend accurately. And knight g5 was already a mistake, and now he's already lost. So we had to find knight g3. Oh my god. This is not working. What other knight moves? It's amazing. This position, this might also be a draw actually. But wait. F3, knight f4. Yeah, this actually might be a draw. But it feels so close to a win. I can't bring my king over. King d3, king f3. What's happening? Yeah, I'm winning, no? What is he playing? Yeah, this plan of king d3 over here, just winning and exchanging the bishop for the knight. So, yeah, this is not a draw, I think. So, yeah, this looks winning, maybe. So, the amazing discovery in this game is that in this particular position, move 66, he had to find knight g3 with I guess less than 10 seconds on the clock or something. The move in itself is not the most difficult to play, I think, because every capture is a stalemate, but just the logic behind it is insane. The fact that he has knight h5 and here he has knight f1. Yeah, it's quite insane. So yeah, after this, I think it was already too much. Yeah, now it's just lost. He tried his last trick, but I guess if I don't take, so yeah, it's still winning actually. Okay, so and it didn't work. So h3, the fastest mate in this position. Yeah, just would have been winning easily. So this was a very interesting endgame, and I think the we had a few fantastic discoveries. I could use many exercises from this game if one day I decide to stop playing for let's say above 2700 rating and so on, to just improve my chess exclusively. If I decide to just become a trainer one day, I can get at least three different exercises from this game. But I hope this day will be as far from today as possible, and that I won't have to become a trainer and be able to play chess for the near future as a player. I find it much more, let's call it, rewarding from my own improvement point of view. Okay, so much more challenging, let's say it this way. So we saw the fourth game. Let's look at the last game. I see someone sent a message. So let's see in this particular game analysis. Okay, this is the last one for the day. D4. I was white. I decided to play the London, and we had this interesting aggressive setup. Here, my game against the Polish guy was Bishop G7. I completely forgot his name, actually. I feel like looking it up for a second. Let's have a look. Just played him in Bill, and he, in the first four rounds, he managed to beat me and draw with Vitugov and Berkic. So where is it? Yeah, Mroziak, Maciej, something like this. Very talented young player from Poland. So B5, I played A3, Bishop G7, E4 looks good. I remember looking at it after the game as the improvement. Yeah, and this just looks better for white, but yeah. As I mentioned, when in doubt, King B1 is always a good move. But don't quote me on this, in case you lose. And I just think it's a good rule of thumb. And yeah, Bishop G4 looks really good for me. And in this position, H4. It's not such a bad move. G4 is what the computer wants, but practically speaking, yeah, he doesn't want to take. So, yeah, Rook F1 is actually very strong. Yeah, but suddenly... Okay, but I didn't want to give so much counterplay. Bishop d4 is something I had to foresee, which I didn't. Yeah, but as I evaluated, I was right that thinking that this is not very clear. Okay, so h4 was quite deep, preparing potentially rook h3 and g4 with some faster attack. And after knight a6, I could take, avoiding knight c6 ideas. And it feels like I'm much better here, but I just couldn't put my finger on it. So knight ec3. I was really thinking for a long time. I saw this line, but I wasn't convinced. If I go rook b8, knight a7 is the point. Ah, so the a7 pawn is hanging. And if rook c4, bishop a7, come on. You gotta be kidding me. Okay, so bishop a7 is the deadly point for white. I think, yeah, this is also much better. So I should have just played knight ec3. This is the most educated move, just to avoid giving counterplay and releasing this bishop, which is stuck. So, yeah, thought for a long time. Despite being much better still, I think, like, at least it's easier for black to make moves here, because I have to come up with a convincing way. And now knight d5, yeah, well, this was the most convincing way to play. I realized it 1 second later when he played knight b6. He can defend, and now e5, maybe. Yeah, and white is better. So it feels good. Instead, in this position I went e5, allowing knight b6, and knight a6 is actually interesting, preventing a5. I kind of saw it, but it felt right to just attack f7, and I completely forgot that a5 is a tempo on the knight, and I ruined all my advantage. Had I played knight a6, followed by rook f2, I think it's gonna be very difficult for black. Yeah. The knight is a great blockader, and actually you don't see very often a knight blockading a pawn just from a6, just like this. It's kind of a unique blockade. So many creative things took place in this match. Now my position is not much better. I couldn't see a way to finish it, to convert, let's say. In this position I should have played h5, but what's the follow-up? Let's say it goes like in the game, something like this. Takes, takes, and what next? Where's the arrow? I don't even see. Ah, rook e1. Okay, but it's not very convincing to me. So I was trying to be more aggressive. I played g4, which was a mistake. I was hoping for some h6, forcing some bishop h8 ideas. And then maybe have some back rank mating tactics with e6 and so on, some traps. But I couldn't get h6 in. And rook e1. Yeah, hg was a mistake in time pressure. h6 now, oh my god. I saw it actually after playing rook e1 with the idea of knight e5 here. But it just felt wrong. I mean, it felt too creative. It's actually extremely strong. H6 was a winning, or let's say a very powerful move. Just nailing, putting this nail in the coffin of the black position. HG was just a mistake. Now knight e5, I thought, would give me more chances. But yeah, I'm not even attacking f7, so... I feel glad I didn't play it. And here I had some chances. And the way the game took place, he actually fell for my trap. Rook f4. He was going for mate, where in fact it's not working because I can take on a4. And I'm completely winning. I just have to prevent counterplay. So rook f4 prevents all counterplay and the game is essentially finished. Just push the pawns on the queen side. But instead I went rook a7. Rook f2, a4, still should be completely winning, but b4 didn't feel too easy. If I just take, this feels a bit complicated because this pawn is running quite fast. So instead of b4, can I go something else, c4? It's already quite complicated. King somewhere. Yeah, so in the game I went here, it's looking good actually to my eyes. Take with the rook. I should have taken with the c pawn. And then he has to waste a move. Rook a8 coming and I'm promoting very quickly. Yeah, and here I blundered, I overlooked the rook takes a4. King b3 was stronger. Still, feels like I should be close to winning. Rook c5, king somewhere. Yeah, just b4, oh my god, just b4, and b5, but, and b6, wow, just sacrificing the rook. Yeah, and this is just winning, at least practically. I don't think he can get a fortress going, so, yeah, I should just run quickly with this pawn. King c4 looks even more to the point, but apparently f3 is forcing a king move. Ah, because it's a check at the end. So f3, king d3. What's the difference? Could have gone king d3 there as well. So why is it such a big difference? No, it's the same. f2. Is this a draw? Looks like white is better. b6. What can he even do? Rook f8? Aha, king c8. What a lovely position. Rook c2, g5, and if I take, it looks winning. It's easily winning, come on. Rook e8. Why would this be a draw? Come on. Gotta be kidding me. I just go collect this pawn and I will win easily. Okay, so this is still winning. Okay, so here, instead of an extra king move, b4 was completely winning, and this has been the final mistake of the match, because this is just a draw. And as I said, it's an interesting finish for an interesting struggle. And I'm very happy that Christof accepted my challenge. I contacted him on Facebook and on the email, and he was very kind to accept, because obviously he's been around for a long time and he has a lot of followers. So I'm very thankful to Christof for agreeing, and I hope we can get more matches like this in the future, and hopefully we'll have a chance to get his revenge, because obviously he was demonstrating much stronger chess than the results that took place. And yeah, let's have a quick look at the chat before I go on and finally get some dinner going. So, six pieces or less. Book has perfect knowledge. It's called an Alimov database. There's even a database for seven pieces if someone is willing to actually pay money for it. It's called the Lomonosov database or table base. It's actually fascinating to analyze some rook endgame positions which are considered to be better for white, and see a final result, if it's whether it's winning or a draw. So just an example is the videos series on Chess24 by Mark Dvoretsky, together with Jan Gustafsson, on rook endgames. Some of the explanations are just fantastic and very deep. And when he mentions that Dvoretsky mentioned he was checking with the Lomonosov table base, this position is winning, this one is a draw, I was just completely amazed, staring at the screen. So let's have a look. So thanks for the compliments, W Juice, and all the advice about the leeches. Next time I actually will try to arrange some common shared analysis. I mean, somehow, I'm not sure how to do it yet, because there is some echo on Skype if I'm just using it. I have to integrate it into my streaming program somehow, and I'm not a big tech guy. So I have to figure out how to do it in my future streams, after the games, to analyze together with my opponent. I think it would be much more fun and interactive, and see what they were thinking. And also on leeches, I know there is a function where we can just analyze together. We both can make moves and make arrows and so on. So I think it would be nice. I have to figure all these things out. Thanks. For those of you who don't know, I'm sorry about the pronunciation, but Thibault Duplessis here is the guy who, as far as I can, as I know, who initiated all the idea behind leeches, and probably without him, leeches wouldn't have existed. So I think he is a programmer, so correct me if I'm wrong. And yeah. You're saying that this stream was awesome, but everything you did to the chess community is far more amazing than anything I would do, probably. So, yeah, this is great. And, yeah. And I hope to do more streams. I'm not sure if I'll do only on leeches, but I'll definitely do it where the people want. And the audience seems to really like this site, so... I'll definitely keep doing it here and there. What about a match against Astane? Actually, I talked to Astane about this possibility. It's definitely an option, but I mean, he's a really good coach and is not too active as a player. So he's very talented at explaining chess-related positions and verbalizing his thoughts and so on. So I think he was also good at interviewing. So generally speaking, I will do more collabs with Astana in the future. My gut feeling tells me that it will have something to do with commentary or analysis and so on, or just Q&A like previously. But if we decide to do a match, I'm definitely up for it. It just feels like I have a little bit of an edge being a more active player and so on. So let's see. Yeah, share a board, make a study. Okay, so I will read all the chat messages from the beginning after the stream, and I'll see all your advice and try to learn more about the Elite Chess server and so on. I hope I'll become an expert within the next month or so. In a week or so also I will go to the Olympiad, so this is kind of my main focus now, and I'm hoping that the openings will go much better and I'll be equally lucky. So this part is very important for me. It's been my dream for the last 10 years, so I hope I'll be able to play well and represent Israel let's say in a good way. So yeah, so I see, thanks for the explanation yeah, thanks for the kind words, everyone. Words. Software engineer. I think it's similar to programmer. Yeah. So. Yeah. I'll talk to Astana about the possibility. I have other ideas on my plate. I mean, I'm not sure. After the Olympiad, I'll try to arrange as many collaborations as possible, if I can afford it and have the time. It's definitely fun. So I don't know. I have many different people on my mind. I'm basically contacting every chess player, chess YouTuber who I can find, who we might help each other getting some exposure, or at least create very interesting content and challenge each other. So. I just to name a few, John Bartholomew, I hope he will still be interested next month. There is Greg Shahadi. I don't know if it will work out, but I'll try to contact Niklas Uschenbeet and Chess Brian, whoever might want to do more Banter Blitz. So basically every possible content I can create with together with other internet personalities. Maybe even Simon Williams, who knows. So there are many interesting people out there who play chess and share the passion for the game. And just to say some conclusion about a vote I had some time ago on my channel, about 3 weeks ago. So when I reached 1,000 subscribers, I asked people which type of content they would prefer. And other than the usual Blitz, I will also upload some analysis related material. Obviously there will be a little bit of everything, but I'll make some focus on the analysis. Although it's hard to find the time to do it seriously, so I'll try to record at least one game before the Olympiad, where I analyze one of my games against the members of the Israeli team. It's hard to pick a good game because in every encounter one of us played a little bit less than ideal, and I don't want to draw them in a negative way, in negative light. So. Let's see. Yeah, I will do my best to become a Elite Chess expert. Yeah. Only 1 week before Olympiad, exactly. I'm excited. I have no idea what's waiting me. What's waiting for me. So, yeah. 10 days technically, but in about 8-9 days we are flying. We have the flight. So... F3 Nimtso FTW. I'm not sure what FTW means, but yeah, I was hoping to get some F3 nimzo here, but he wanted to play the Benko. So let's see. Yeah. Every player is most welcome. The more challenging, the better. So yeah, if there'll be streamers tournaments with or without prizes, I would love to play. And I mean, basically, I think my channel has some potential to create some good content for chess lovers around the world, and I would love more people to be exposed to it. So yeah, I don't really care about bitcoins and money prizes on the internet. It's not very big anyway, and even if it was, like, I don't have any immediate need for money. So I feel like it's a good idea to just focus on my own chess, as I mentioned many times in my channel. So before, so foot the walk. I don't know. Is this FTW? So yeah, Lichess is improving. Yeah, I really hope so. It would be great. It's great news, and yeah, I don't have any particular plans for the channel other than just keep creating content for all the chess players out there on a daily basis. As long as I can afford to spend the time, it's definitely fun. So yeah, so to summarize the stream, for those who didn't see the entire games, final result was 4-1 in my favor against ChessExplained. I didn't play as well as my result, I think, or to be more exact, he played much better than his final result, but it was very interesting, and I'm sure we both learned something from it. And if you want to be notified next time I have streams, I think the best way to do it is to subscribe to the channel, and you'll get a notification next time I stream, because I'm not very organized with it, so usually I do it quite spontaneously. So yeah, it was really fun, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Feel free to leave comments in the archived version and suggest anything for improvement. And yeah, I'll see you guys later on in my future streams. So thanks a lot for watching, and yeah, don't have much anything smart to say, just keep playing chess and improving. See you guys soon.